While delivering the State of Nation address today, President Yoweri Museveni assured the country that the economy is projected to grow by 5.5% in the next financial year 2023-2024 compared to 4.7% of the financial year 2021-2022. He explained that the growth is projected to arise from economic stability, more factories, PDM implementation, oil and gas, and regional trade growth. The GDP is projected to grow to 207.22 trillion at the end of the next financial year.
Over the next 5 years, the economy is projected to grow at an average rate of 6.57% per year. This growth will arise from 1. Economic stability as a result of low inflation, 2. Establishment of more manufacturing plants, factories, continued implementation of the Parish Development Model, 4. Support to small and medium-scale enterprises through MEOGA SACCOs, the Youth and Women Funds and other initiatives, 5. Increased oil and gas sector activities.
Museveni hailed increased growth of household incomes, which have increased by 60%, and committed to double government efforts in creation of wealth.
Although the country has been faced with economic shocks, household businesses have responded positively to government investments in especially infrastructure and the various wealth creation initiatives. As a result, 60% of households have increased their incomes in the year ending December 2022 compared to 43% whose incomes increased in the same period a year ago.
Government contemplates on introducing subsidies on fertilizers whose supply has been heavily affected by the Russia-Ukraine war.
For inputs into production such as fertilizers, it may be logical to look at subsidies. We are studying this. Our policy as government is to allow demand and supply forces to determine prices and incentivize production. However, on the issue of fertilizers, we shall either get a solution to stop the Western countries interfering with our supply of fertilizers.
President Museveni has decried increased cases of corruption in the parish vomit model, saying his tours in different parts of the country have unearthed rot in the government flagship program to deliver socio-economic transformation. The president disclosed government will prioritize infrastructure that supports industrialization, production of oil and gas, and promote tourism by developing more industrial parks, electricity power substations, extending and upgrading electricity transition lines, water for industrial use, and ICT, among others, in the next financial year.
Government continues to implement 16 projects to upgrade over 892 kilometers of national roads to pave the bituminous standards, while at the same time rehabilitating 300 kilometers to restore their service life. Construction of the following roads has been completed, adding 351 kilometers to the paved network.
Museveni stunned the country when he denounced Uganda's Vision 2040, whose primary aim is to see Uganda become a middle-income country by 2040. Museveni noted that the Vision 2040 is too slow to deliver Uganda's desired development. The president sent a strong caution on government officials who make life difficult for foreign investors to bring investments into the country. He vowed to clamp down however solicits bribe from investors.
God would not like it. In the cattle corridor, you were there the other day, you the MPs, you were there in the cattle corridor, you saw in Ngoma. People have nice houses and income, even when the infrastructure is not there. You saw the road from very bad, the road is not good, but the people have income.
Museveni also spoke out on the rising cases of gun violence across the country, saying misuse of firearms is being handled by addressing discipline among security forces and enhancing security capacity to detect crime. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.